and welcome to the 7th grade concert. We're starting out there with a Herbie Hancock favorite, Chameleon. Really great jazz standard that's been around for a very long time, and they love playing it, as you can see. Really nice, funky tune. You heard on flute, Abby Hong on flute, and guitar, great soloist, also Griffin Harvey. You got a soloist award for that one during our jazz festival season. Abby did as well. She got a soloist award. We traveled around to three different schools, middle schools around the area. We went to Upper Moreland, we went to Quakertown, Strayer. We also went to, we had our home show here, we went to Penfield. So a really great season that we had. And for those of you who don't know, it's kind of like our games in a sense, for, you know, think of a sports team. That's our competition season. We get to go around to the neighboring district schools. They host this great festival. Several different jazz bands, anywhere between, you know, 5 and 10 jazz bands throughout the night. We had a great night here at Pennbrook, the first one we've had in over 3 years, because prior to, you know, what happened in the past couple of years, we got snowed out before that. So it was quite a while since we were able to have a festival. Really great to get back to that this year, as well as my first one. And it actually, we were able to raise enough funds throughout the night to purchase these wonderful ties, as you see tonight. So. They really, our Pembroke spirit is coming through with our blue and red. We're going to feature some more soloists on our next tune, a Van Morrison favorite, Moon Dance. Thank you. Some great soloists we heard there on Moondance. We had Leilani Williams on tenor sax. Ian Belisa-Lisa on trumpet. Ian Roush on trombone. And Aruka Ware on alto sax as well. Great jazz standard, great swing tune. Also, a hand for Jack there being on our microphone stand for our trumpet and our trombone there playing for the soloists. All right, we're gonna keep this rolling. We have a third tune. This is a really, really made well-known, I would say probably Birdland being done by Maynard Ferguson, probably most recently for most people know this by. Really great tune, developed during the 70s. And he just took it worldwide with his band, and it's one of their favorites to play. It's actually been a standard here for Pennbrook Jazz Ensemble for many years prior to me, under the direction of Mr. Peter New, who was the director here for over 33 years. So I'm not sure if he's around. He's probably gigging tonight, but I just wanted to give a shout out to Mr. New for all that he's done for here at Pennbrook and North Penn. A round of applause for him as well. Here's Birdland. Thank you. right, and that was Birdland. You heard on trumpet Ian Blizzalisa. And Angelina Yang on alto sax. I just want to thank all those, especially all the directors that are involved with tonight to really make this all happen. It's been quite a long year. Getting everything back to normal and kind of getting back into the swing of these concerts has been rough, and getting everybody ready as well. It's been a lot of hard work. So really a round of applause for all these conductors out here. You know, we're looking forward to the next. Several great groups coming up next. And also our administration, Mrs. Rita Whalen, Dr. Jenkins, our supervisor, our facility supervisor, Chris Osgood, and all the custodians. Give a round of applause for them. Really making this all happen. They're really crucial for our jazz festival and all our concerts going through, making sure that the behind the scenes stuff really comes together. And I'm just really trying to fill in a lot of time because, as you can see, we're swapping out some things over here. We have some really talented folks in this band. Really gonna be sad to see some of them leave, which I would like to recognize those that will be moving on from Pennbrook as Pennbrook alumni and moving on to the North Penn High School. Ninth graders, could you please stand up? Rupa Ware on alto sax, Leilani Williams on tenor sax. We have Neil Nand on bass, and you're going to hear him on guitar in a little bit. Derek Rajan on keyboard. We have Lucas Bediri on drum set. Ian Roush, Jack Woodland, Manav Trivedi on trombone. Ian, Billy Zalisa, and Alex Erb on trumpet. A round of applause for my ninth graders. Not only are they great musicians, but they are great student leaders as well. One thing I really try to get ninth graders in this year is really to take over that leadership role, and they did a great job with that. So thank you, folks. And raise your hand if you're in eighth grade. So we got some eighth graders still. Raise your hand if you're in seventh grade. So as you can see, we have quite a mix in this band, seventh, eighth, and ninth grade, and a great representation of all three. So really, as you can see going forward, for those of you who may have been had folks, you know, little ones that were questioning jazz band, maybe I'm not ready. As you can see, it's a great mix. Our music is a lot of fun to play, and you can see it all comes together, especially with the support of the older folks in the band. We're gonna close out this night with a great tune, a great punk tune, punk rock tune, almost heavy metal-ish as well. We'll see Neil be playing guitar, and also I wanted to point out Griffin back here, he's actually switching back to bass guitar, and not only has he done that, but in the eighth grade concert, he was playing drum set. So we have some, like I said, we have some really versatile folks in the band. So here is Steampunk. We'll be right back.
Irish Barber by Larry Clark is a song for classical string instruments written in a way that the instruments sound like the bagpipes of Scotland. The word bobber is an old Scottish word for dance. The lower strings are used in a way that makes them sound like a set of bagpipes. This also assists in setting the mood of a lighthearted melody. While we were learning this, there were many bumps along the way, from guesses of what bobber meant to having trouble to the occasionally fast tempo. Larry Clark is an ASCAP award-winning composer and sought after. His music has also been featured in some of Warner Brothers' films. And thank you to Simran Patel and Aisha Sononi for finding the information. And anyway, I'm sure you would rather hear what you can see instead of listening to me rain on. So without further ado, enjoy.
Nice work. By the way, I should point out that we had a misprint in tonight's program, so the order that we are doing these songs, some might not even be in the program. The first one was Scottish Bobber by Larry Clark. Now, for number two.
My name is Isabel Kleiber. Our second song will be O Mio Babbio Caro, which is an Italian opera piece from Gianni Cicci, which translates to My Beloved Daddy. The name of the arranger is Sandra Dachau, and it was composed in 1918. So the story of this piece is this girl has fallen in love with a boy. But her dad does not like this boy. So she threatens to do some bad things, and this is the story of her complaining to her father in her nice, sweet voice.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Of course, the soft voice referred to was the second part of the song, with the first part of the song being that expression of true teenagery angst at having to ask the question in the first place. So I just thought I'd point that out. Next.
My name is Elliot Hanrahan. Allegretto from the 7th Symphony was composed by the German composer Beethoven in 1812. And arranged by Robert Longfield. It first premiered at a concert in Vienna in 1813. It is a boisterous piece which fuses joyful melodies with vigorous peaks and tones. Although the melody follows a simple pattern, it creates a work that is unforgettable.
Thank you.
Elliot's description, of course, applied to the first and very boisterous first movement of the symphony, this one being the third movement, the slow, pensive movement. It's more of a steady beat in this particular movement that we discussed. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming out tonight. Just so you know, there's a lot more music coming. There is the chorus, there is the band. A lot of great music is coming for you tonight. So don't go, enjoy the rest of the show. It was an honor to have worked with these kids this year, and I really, really, really look forward to working with them next year to see what more I can give them and how much greater and how much more they can expand their technique during their very tricky eighth grade year. Oh yes, I do look forward to that. Thank you very much. And now for our final piece.
My name is Haley, and I will be announcing the last song, It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing, from Sophisticated Ladies by Duke Ellington, Irving Mills, and it was arranged by Robert Longfield. It is an upbeat and lively song, now considered a jazz standard. I hope you enjoy this song as much as we enjoy playing it for you.
My name is Aya Zarwell, and I sing soprano in the 7th grade chorus. Only I is by Jim Popolis. Our soloist is Yashvi Patel on the bongos, Amina Amari on the shaker, and Samantha Badziak on the tambourine. In Arabic, Taqbil al-Akhiru means acceptance of others. Aqbil ya'ahtimini means acceptance comes from me. The text, with the message that celebrates humanity and acceptance, does so use both English and Arabic as a way of celebrating cultures that make up a significant part of our community. Arabic phrases the style and voice leading mix with contemporary harmonies to create a piece that really celebrates all.
Hello, my name is Justin Arminati, and I sing baritone in 7th grade chorus. Our soloists are Celia Francois, hand drum, small group, Aaliyah Coulter, Fiona Kaur, Sophia Hoffman, Ashton Kelsey, Ava Law, Jillian Odie, Jesse Ustazen, Gianna Stahl, and Esther Soul. Yuli is the opening musical number for the 2013 Disney animated feature Frozen. This song is inspired by indigenous Sami and Norwegian culture and was written and composed by Norwegian composer Frode Fjellum. Fjoli is the South Sami word for yoik. A yoik is both a type of Sami song and a unique vocal style used to perform this, often referred to as chanting.
Ensemble, we have a lot of 7th graders, and they won a superior rating with a ranking of 95 out of 100. That's the highest we've ever gotten. Very, very exciting. I want to thank a few people and just remind you what's happening next. Sometimes we sing our portion and then we're done, but we're not done after this final song with just our portion. After us will be band, and then we come back in for a rousing patriotic salute, patriotic medley. So we are going to get started with our final reader for our portion tonight. Thank you so much for supporting your changing voices. I can only imagine, you know, in the car, in the shower, it really makes a difference, those positive reinforcement that you can say, and not just always like, what was that, you know? It's really important to keep them singing through this change and to just give them, you know, the encouragement as they all need at 13, 14 years old. So we are continuing with Nicest Kids in Town.
Thank you. Austin, and I sing soprano in the 7th grade chorus. The Nicest Kids in Town is the musical from Airspring. Our soloists are Lucy McKee on drums, Neil on hard bass, and Jesse Ustis on bass. Set in Baltimore in the 1960s, these stories centers around a televised teenage dance show and its host, Corny Collins. In this song, the character Corny Collins sings the lead, while the background female voice vocals sing musical quotes from several of our choruses. Most popular songs of that era.
Practice. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, thank you so much for coming out tonight. This is the 7th grade band. They just played March of the Irish Guard. Yeah. We can clap as much as we want for them. March of the Irish Guard was fun for us. We got to play in a time signature called 6-8 in the middle. You heard the snare drums holding it down back there. So it was awesome for them to hear them learn that as we went through the beginning of this concert season here. We have one more piece that we're going to play just by ourselves for you tonight called Renegade Dances. I wanted to do Renegade Dances because I don't know if y'all have heard of TikTok. I don't know if y'all have heard of The Renegade. Does anybody want to show them what The Renegade looks like? Well, when we were in the band room a second ago, they were all doing it. Now they're all embarrassed. I don't know. So we're going to do a piece called Renegade Dances for you. Renegade Dances. That was Renegade Dances. We go back and forth between two different tempos. They were a little shocked by how fast it was at first. We have one more piece for you this evening. And it is not just us. We are going to have the chorus come on forward and join us. We're going to have a combined chorus and band play a patriotic festival.